really nasty head wound there. Oh dear. We'll definitely have to get you seen to. It's not a problem. Are you in a lot of pain just now? Yeah. Okay. Right, have a wee sit down for me. What we're going to do is we're going to just look through your head injury and we'll work out what we need to do next, okay? So I'm the doctor here in the A&E department. My name is Dr. Murmurs. And I'm just going to have a quick look at your head, okay? Let's have a wee look. Okay. You've got kind of a laceration down there. Okay. You've got a laceration to the head. Okay, it's probably looks like it's going to need stitches. Okay, you've got pain anywhere else? Ribs? Okay, how far up? Okay, so kind of maybe your upper third. Okay, what happened? So you fell off a ladder. I see. What were you doing? Fixing things for the wife? I see. What's she doing getting you all up there fixing things for her? Yeah, what I'm going to do is, first of all, your head looks like the most kind of serious injury that we need to stop just now. And then I'll have a wee look at your ribs, I'll further examine you, okay? I'm just going to gently kind of leave it here. I'm just going to dab off some of the kind of blood around your head, okay? You poor thing, what are you like, honestly? Okay, now I'm gonna have to take off. We'll start with the head injury first, and I'm gonna have to take off just a wee bit of hair surrounding the area of your laceration, okay? Okay, let's get in there a little bit more. Of hair there in your forehead. Just pulling that off. Okay. Right, I just need to have a wee look and see how deep this is. See if there's any kind of dirt or anything I need to take out of it, okay? to put in a little anesthetic around the area. Okay, so you're gonna feel a really sharp prick and then you'll be fine, okay? That's it. Okay, all done. Okay, so just wait a moment and we're just gonna let the kind of anesthetic settle in and you should be able to feel no pain because you've got quite a bit of dirt in there. But I've got my microscope to look at it. Just getting together some of my tools. I've got a lot of them easy. It's nothing to worry about. Okay. Okay, right, so let me just tap your head. Can you feel this? And then I'm going to put on a little kind of cream to just an antiseptic. Yeah, just to help you out a little bit so we can stop infection. Okay. Now you'll feel the hooks, but, well, you won't really. You'll feel no pain, but you might feel a wee kind of tugging sensation. Of antiseptic cream on there, okay. Okay, and I'm just gonna wrap this bandage around your head, okay? In place and I'll just cut off the bandage. few stitches. We'll just have a look, right? So we'll just tap you. Okay. I'm just going to, where's my prongs? There. Right, sit tight, okay. I'm not going to put anesthetic in this one. I just want you to sit tight. I'm just going to quickly check. Yeah, it looks a lot cleaner. It's not as deep a laceration as your head. I think we might get away with butterfly stitches. It's basically like just a kind of gel-like formula that I'll just put along the laceration line. And we'll hold it together for about a minute, and that should do the job, okay? Okay, that's excellent. It's stuck together perfectly. Okay, now your ribs. Let me just have a wee look. Okay, can you just put your arms up like this for me? That's it. Oh, is it tender there? Okay. Can I feel down? Okay, so it seems that's not that sore there, is it? Okay. It just seems like an upper. Yeah. I'm just gonna give that right, and I need to kind of feel if it's broken. I'm really sorry if it's this sore. Okay, breathe in. And breathe out. Again for me, breathe in and breathe out. I think it might just be really badly bruised. Yeah, it's not really sharp pain when you breathe in, is it? No, it's just generally quite sore. Yeah, I can't feel any kind of gaps within the ribs themselves. They seem fairly smooth to me. You've not really kind of swollen much up in that area. The skin's not shiny. Yeah, there's just quite a lot of bruising around there. I'm going to come around the back of you and just check your back ribs, okay? Okay. Right, can you breathe in again for me? That's it, okay. I'll be really gentle. Okay, breathe out. Yeah, okay. Thank you. Yeah, you did really, really well. Okay, so I think that I am pretty sure I'm right about this. I think it's just bruising. I don't think we need to x-ray you. I think that obviously if it continues to be sore or progressively sore, you need to come back in and see us or call your GP and they can schedule an appointment with us. But for now, I think you're fine. We'll give you some painkillers because there's not much we can do with broken ribs anyway. We usually just get you to have quite a lot of bed rest and we give you painkillers. I'm going to do that anyway because you need some ibuprofen to take down the swelling. I'll also give you cocodamol for the pain. And that should, you should be absolutely sorted. Now you'll need to come back in to see us to get the stitches taken out. Obviously not the butterfly stitches, you're fine, that's just a kind of gel glue-like substance, you're fine. But you will have to come back and see me to get your head injury out. Yeah. If you notice any kind of discoloration or discharge coming out of any of your lacerations, you need to be seen by a GP because there's a good chance that you will be infected. It's not to worry about. If there is a slight infection there, we will just give you floxacillin. It's just an antibiotic that's mainly for kind of skin infections. It's not really much to worry about, but you do want to really keep the cuts clean. You can buy Savlon or Germaline from Boots or somewhere like that perhaps. If you want to just kind of keep that the kind of antiseptic part over it, that's absolutely fine. You want to take your head bandage off probably tomorrow, I would say. Yeah, because the air is really, really good at helping heal the cuts. If you keep them really closed up all the time, then it's not going to heal as fast. Absolutely. Yes, you might have a scar. It is a deep laceration on your head. I'm hoping the scar on your face does kind of minimise over time. You can get some bio oil. That helps. We also have scar reduction sedum. Now, some of that you can get prescribed from your doctor. It just really depends. Yeah, it depends. I mean, it is right on your face, but I'm sure, probably if it is going to be an issue, then you should be able to get on the NHS. Yeah. I'm trying to think if there's anything else to tell you. I think that's pretty much it. I think you need looked after, a lot of love and attention. Yeah, you want to take easy bed rest. If you feel unwell at all, especially in terms of concussion, I don't think you have concussion, but if you feel your vision kind of starts to go or you feel a bit confused and disorientated, do come in and see us. Absolutely. We do not want concussion. Yeah, just come back in and see us. Okay, well, thank you very much for coming in to see us. Well, keeping me in the job. Please take better care of yourself. All right. Okay, see you later. Bye.